I've tested and reviewed nearly every launch monitor under 10 grand, and there's one that I keep coming back to as my pick for most people for a lot of reasons, and that is this, the FlightScope Mevo Plus. Today I'm gonna give you 10 reasons why I think this thing is so good and it's such a good fit for most people. That being said, it's not perfect and it is definitely not for everybody. So at the end of the video, I'm gonna tell you some of the things I don't like it, because some of those might be deal breakers based on your particular needs. So let's not wasting time, let's jump right into the video. Two things you need to know real quick. One, if you're still not sure if this is the right one for you, go take my 30-second quiz. You're gonna answer a few questions about what you're looking for, and then I'm gonna give you my best recommendation for a launch monitor based on your needs. That link is right there below. You can even go do that while you're watching this video. Second, if you do decide to buy the FlightScope Mevo Plus, you can use the promo code BREAKING80PLUS. You will save 5%, but I will get a commission on that. But if you think that makes me biased or you don't trust me because of it, totally understand. You can go straight to FlightScopeMevo.com, bypass those affiliate links, bypass that coupon code. No hard feelings. But I truly believe in this product, and honestly, I don't care if you buy it or not. I shoot these videos to try and help you make the best buying decisions you can so that you end up with products that you love. With that out of the way, let's talk about the reasons I love this product, and at the end, we're gonna talk about some things I don't love about it. Number one, let's talk about one of the biggest things right up front, and that is there are no subscription fees at all with the FlightScope Mevo Plus. As you're doing your research, if you're looking at other launch monitors, you will find almost every single one has a significant subscription fee. Some of the subscription fees are as much as 25% of the cost of the device. So the fact the FlightScope Mevo Plus offers you so much and you pay one time and never have to pay anything else if you don't want to, I think that's one of the biggest selling points for this particular device. Second reason I love this is the data is so customizable. When you go into the FlightScope app, not only will you get all the metrics you want, but you can configure which metrics are shown. You can set parameters. So if you want to say, okay, I want to make sure my angle of attack is between -2 and +2, you can set those parameters so that the box change colors after every swing. So you can visually see if you're hitting a good shot or a bad shot based on the metrics you're targeting. Not only that, you can view your shots and your groups of shots and your sessions in all kinds of ways. Whether you want an overview scatter chart, whether you want to see a shot tracer, whether you just want to see your carry distance in big numbers, you can customize all of that. And it truly feels like a professional device in that manner, in part because if you were to buy the FlightScope X3, their super high-end five-figure launch monitor, you're essentially getting the same software. And you can do all of that with this for a fraction of the price. So when it comes to data, customizability, how you display it, how you use it, I'm not sure I've tested a product that gives you as many options and is as easy or enjoyable to use in that regard. One thing I will note is the app does feel a little dated at times, especially when you compare it to the SkyTrack Plus or the full swing kit, but the data you can get and what you can do with it, it does feel more professional as opposed to consumer level. And generally I found these professional level softwares don't feel as user friendly to the average person. So just something to keep in mind. Number three is simulator flexibility. You can use so many different simulator solutions with this device. If you want to use Awesome Golf, great, you can do it. If you want to use GS Pro, great, you can do it. If you want to use the Golf Club 2019, you can do it. It comes with a free E6 Connect package that's honestly better than the package that comes with most similar devices for a couple reasons. So first off, the one that comes with the Mevo Plus is both for PC and mobile. A lot of the launch monitors that you'll find that come with E6 access, it's only mobile. So you can only use it on your iPad or your phone, but this comes for your PC as well. So that means you're gonna get better performance, better graphics, and more flexibility if you're actually building out a true simulator setup. We'll talk a little bit later on about some of the options you get with the Mevo Plus, but this one is the latest and greatest. This is their limited edition, which comes with both the Pro package, impact detection, and a special E6 offer, which includes both Pebble Beach and the Old Course. So this is like top of the line. If you want everything the Mevo Plus can do, the limited edition is the one to get. But if this has some features you don't need and you don't want to pay for them, then you can get the regular Mevo Plus. But like I said, we're going to talk a little bit more about that and what those options are later in the video. But honestly, I think the fact you can buy this and play Pebble Beach for no additional cost and no subscription, I mean, that's awesome. Number four is the Mevo Plus, even though it's less expensive than a lot of other products, it has a lot of features that other products don't have. There's three specifically that come to mind. One of the first unique features that you just don't see on that many other launch monitors is an environmental optimizer. That means you can go in, you can set the temperature, the pressure, the altitude, all sorts of different metrics that are going to essentially simulate you being in a different environment. A couple of use cases might be, let's say you live in Florida, but you're getting ready to go golf in Colorado and the course you're playing at is like 5,200 feet above sea level. You can go put that altitude and maybe that location's temperature in, and all of a sudden the Mevo Plus is going to give you data as though you were playing under those conditions. Or let's say you're going out to practice and it's super windy and super cold, so you know your ball's not going to be flying as far as it usually does. You can normalize those conditions so it's more like you're playing at sea level on a windless 70 degree day. Having that flexibility and being able to control the environment is a really welcome feature. It's been nice to see FlightScope update the environmental optimizer for 2024, making it even more robust and even more useful. There's also Live Tracer. So you can set this up on the range and you use your phone, and it's going to give you a live video with a shot tracer with data overlay of your practice sessions. So you're gonna be able to watch your screen, see what the ball does via shot tracer. You're gonna be able to see what the apex is. You're gonna see what the carry distance of your shot is. And there's no other launch monitor that I know of that can do that live and in real time. For some, that might seem a little bit gimmicky, but say you hit a really good shot and you wanna save that and you wanna see all of your data built into the video, you can do that now, and that's pretty cool. Finally, the third feature that you hardly see in any launch monitors, especially not at this price point, is impact detection. So you hit a ball and it is going to show you exactly where on the club face you hit the ball. And honestly, this has worked surprisingly well. I put some impact tape on a couple of my clubs and used the feature. And honestly, what it was showing me on the screen is almost identical to what I saw on the club. So to get this, you buy the Mevo Plus, then you have to upgrade to the Pro package, then you have to upgrade to the impact detection on top of that. Unless you buy the limited edition, which comes with all of that right out of the gate. I kind of realize right now, if you're just getting familiar with the Mevo Plus, this might not mean much to you. So the basic Mevo Plus is going to come with all of your ball data. It comes with all of these metrics I'm listing on the screen right now. But if you want all the deep plane data about your swing, face to path, face to target, club path, and more, you've got to get the Pro package. Retail, that's a $1,000 upgrade. Then if you want impact detection, that's a $500 upgrade on top of that. The good news is there are often sales, so you can see those discounted. And if you use that coupon code BREAKING80PLUS, you're going to get a discount on top of that. So if you keep an eye out for sales, you can usually get all of that for right around $3,000. All right, back to the things I love. Number five is fusion tracking. So this was a feature that was on their top of the line X3 that they rolled down to the Mevo Plus and is really cool. So this is a Doppler radar device. That means it's going to use radar to track your ball. But what fusion tracking means is that it not only uses Doppler, but it uses the built-in camera to give you more accurate results. So there are not many products out there that use both Doppler and camera to give you that data. And when they rolled out this free upgrade to all Mevo Plus users a few years ago, I actually saw significant improvements in the accuracy of the results I was getting. So the fact it uses that is pretty cool. Number six is kind of an obvious one, but it's size and portability. A lot of launch monitors, they're pretty big, they're pretty heavy. You're not just gonna be able to throw it in your bag and take it out to the course. Mevo Plus, it's pretty small. Comes with a nice carrying case, which not all launch monitors do. And so if you wanted to just throw this in your bag and leave it in there, you totally could. But if you're someone who's gonna be using this in a variety of places, you take it out to the course, you take it to your backyard, a garage simulator, the fact that it's so easy and so light to be able to pick up and carry around is actually a really nice feature. Number seven is one of the coolest features of the Mevo Plus, and this might be a selling point for some of you that really like to analyze your swing, and that is multicam. So you can use up to four cameras. You can set up four different camera angles, and you can get all of that swing data recorded in real time. So basically, you use your iOS devices, you connect it to the app, you can put one behind you, you can put one on both sides, and then you can also use the built-in camera on the Mevo Plus. Now, four cameras is probably going to be overkill for most people, but to be able to use, say, the built-in camera here, and then set up your iPhone to the side, so that you can see both of those angles, that is really nice. And the fact that you can get that data in real time after every shot is great. And quality-wise, I'll say the built-in camera is not on par with like the full swing kit, which I recently reviewed, but that also costs quite a bit more money and you can't use multicam. You can't set up other cameras. So even though the built-in one isn't great, the fact you can use your iPhone in lieu of that or along with it is awesome. Number eight's only going to apply for some of you, but it's a feature I love, and that's Apple Watch compatibility. So because there is no built-in screen here, that's one of the downsides to it. It can be a little bit of a pain to always have to be looking at your phone or your iPad. If you're using it in bright sunlight, sometimes there's glare. So the fact it syncs up with your Apple Watch and you can customize how that data is displayed. You hit your shot, you just look down at your watch, you get all the data you want. It's super convenient, and I honestly don't understand why more launch monitor companies have not built that in. The only other one I know of is the full swing kit I just mentioned, which also has a great implementation of it. Number nine is that when you buy the Mevo Plus, you can use the software on PC or on mobile. So this is most applicable if you are building out a simulator. Like if you're using mobile E6, the graphic quality just isn't going to be as good. It's going to be a little bit cumbersome. Being able to set all of that up on your PC is awesome. But not only that, say you just want to use the metrics that are in the built-in FlightScope Golf app, there is a PC version of that as well. If you have an older version of the Mevo Plus, that's a $99 upgrade, but if you buy any of the models that are currently on sale new, you get it for free, which I love. And finally, the last reason I think the Mevo Plus is such a good fit for so many people is it's quite simply the best value when it comes to launch monitors. While it's certainly not the cheapest, it's definitely not the most expensive, and the value for what you get is unparalleled. Using sales and coupon codes, you can expect to pick up a base Mevo Plus for probably right around $1,800. Now, all of the stuff we have mentioned in this video, the fact you can get so much of that for $1,800 and the fact it's actually measuring most of these statistics. Whereas you look at cheaper launch monitors, like say the Garmin R10 or the Rapsodo MLM 2 Pro, those are only measuring a handful of statistics, and then they're using algorithms to calculate what it thinks the ball is doing and what it thinks those numbers are going to be. The Mevo Plus is one of the least expensive launch monitors that's actually measuring all of that data, so you know that it's going to be accurate. I personally love the fact that there's no subscriptions, and if you do decide that you want that club data or you want the impact detection, you can simply buy the add-on after the fact. So you can buy the base version, test it out, make sure you like it, and then if you decide, yeah, I really want Club Path, then you can upgrade down the line. So I love the fact that they do that. They don't make you spend more money up front for features that you may not need. You factor all that in with the accuracy, the features that it has that others don't, the simulator flexibility, the portability. It just quite simply is the best value out there. Is it the best at everything? No, it's not. Are there definitely downsides? Yes, there is, and we're going to talk about those in a second. But does it do most things really well for less money than a lot of competitors? It absolutely does, and that's part of the reason why I'm such a big fan of the Mevo Plus. Okay, so now that I've said all of that, I realize this was a very positive video. Like, it probably comes across as borderline a sales pitch. So I want to make sure that I balance this out. There's a reason I do think it is the best overall, but I do not think it is the best for everybody, and I definitely have some complaints. But I do want to make sure you understand the drawbacks, because some of these might be deal breakers, and I want to make sure you have all the information before buying a product. Okay, biggest downside for a lot of people is going to be space. Because this is primarily a Doppler radar unit, it's going to need to sit at least 8 feet behind the ball and have at least 8 feet of ball flight. So if you're planning to use this at home, in your garage, or in a simulator, you're going to need at least 16 feet in order to use this. A lot of people simply don't have that much space. And if that's you, I would recommend you look at a camera-based system that just sits right behind the ball. So you don't need that 8 feet behind, you just need a little bit of room in front of you. So if that's you, the model I would look at are the SkyTrack Plus, the Bushnell Launch Pro, or the Foresight GC3, they're the same unit, or the Unicore iMini. The second major downside is the setup and alignment process is a little bit finicky. So in order to get the most accurate results, especially on the range, you're gonna wanna spend a couple extra minutes to make sure this gets set up properly. So you're gonna wanna make sure that the loft is set at 12 degrees and it's not plus or minus 1 degree either way side to side. The app makes this very easy to do, and then you can use the built-in camera to make sure everything's aligned, but if it's not pretty perfectly set up, you might find some of your data to be inaccurate. Along with that, with this device in particular, you want to make sure it's pretty much exactly level with the ball. I've tested out other Doppler units, specifically the Full Swing Kit, where if it's a couple inches above or a couple inches below, it doesn't really matter, you're still going to get accurate data. Where if you do that with the Mevo Plus, your data is probably going to be a little bit off. So for me personally, at my club, if I'm hitting off the mats at the range there, there's not a solid 8 feet behind me. It kind of drops off into a little bit of a hill. So in order to make sure that I get accurate results, I have to find a way to prop this up so that it sits level with the ball. I figured that out. I know what I do every time. It isn't as big of a deal now, but it did definitely take me a couple sessions and a couple head scratching moments of being like, why isn't this working the way I feel like it should? The good news is their customer service is awesome. So if you have questions or you have problems, you can call them and they do a really good job of walking you through potential troubleshooting issues. Next downside to this is it doesn't have a built-in screen. I'm not gonna lie, the devices that have built-in screens are so nice to use. So let's say you just wanna go out to the range and all you wanna know is your carry distances. You don't wanna fiddle with an app, you don't wanna deal with pairing or doing any of that type of stuff. The fact you can just look down and get your data immediately after your shot with a screen is really nice. With this, one way or another, you're going to have to pair it to an app, which is going to increase that setup time, and it may make it a little bit less convenient to use when you're on the range, depending on which device you're using. That's one of the reasons why if you do have an Apple Watch, I found that to be an excellent way to use this device. So there you go. I could go into a whole lot more detail about things I love and some of the little finicky things I don't love, but I think that hits all of the highlights for my favorite features as well as the biggest drawbacks for me. I've got dedicated reviews I will link to below of both the limited edition version as well as the latest release of the standard Mevo Plus. I will link to the written reviews below, I will link to the YouTube videos below, and I will also link to my most up-to-date best launch monitors video. So if you want to know what I think about some other alternatives out there and some of the competitors, that's a great video to go and watch as well. All that being said, if you have any questions about this, please drop a comment below. Of all the launch monitors I've tested, this tends to be the one that I use the most for my own personal testing and my own personal use, so I'm pretty familiar with it and I can probably help you with any questions or problems that you are having. With that, my name is Sean Ogle. I'm the founder of this thing here, Breaking 80, where we talk about cool golf courses, cool golf products, and golf tech stuff, all of those things. Do all the YouTube-y things, subscribe, like, whatever. If you like this video, if you like me, we've got a whole bunch more videos like this. If you didn't like this video, then, well, thanks for making it this far. I'm impressed. But with that, there's There's links below to all the products I mentioned. Like I said, there's also affiliate links if you decide to buy the product. It helps out this channel a lot. And you save 5% if you use that coupon code. But if that's not cool with you, if you don't trust me because of it, totally understand. You can bypass that just by going to flightscopemevo.com. With that, I hope you have an excellent day. We'll see you on the next video. Peace.